Okay, how to reverse bleed a clutch system. So we've just got a pressurized bottle here. I've just fed this hose down here. We're going to go underneath, just hook that onto our bleeder nipple of our clutch slave cylinder and open it up. That is our first step. The reason we want the bottle up here and not underneath is so that we can watch our level in here and we can actually suck fluid out as we put fluid through. Okay, so under here, our hose coming down from our pressure bottle goes onto our bleeder nipple. Bleeder nipple is loosened off. Okay, and just a side note, of course, this needs to be a perfectly clean bottle before you put brake fluid in it. It can't have any other sort of contaminants in it because you do not want anything else in a clutch or brake system. So we've got this bottle here now. This is just going to suck our fluid out here. Just bring that level down a bit. And then all we're going to do, put some pressure on this. And then as we feed it through, it's going to push through from the bottom and come up into our reservoir. Hence, reverse bleeding, because it's going the opposite way to what the fluid normally does. And I can basically fill that up. And then if I need to, I can suck and put more through. Okay. And then when we're done, we just tighten up our bleeder nipple again. And that is how you reverse bleed a clutch system.
Okay, I hope that has helped you out today. Don't forget to click the like button and also click the subscribe while you're there. We've got a bunch of diagnostic solutions and tips and tricks for professional mechanics like ourselves and also for the serious DIYers at home. So click that subscribe and the bell so you get notified, and we will see you in the next video.